Hello and welcome to this episode of School of Basics. I'm Raghav and today we are going to discuss about IoT or Internet of Things. Now, if you do not know anything about IoT or you have never heard about IoT, do not worry. I will explain everything from scratch and go very basic. To start with, let us take an example. So suppose you step into a huge library, you see books all around. Now, if you have to find or search for a particular book, you can go to the librarian or you can go to the library computer where you will find the data of all the books and you can search for your book based on the title or the author or the subject, and then you will find where exactly which section or which shelf you will find the book. Now just imagine if every book has a tag or a sensor which can have all the information about its location and all the information about the details of the book, and it can directly interact with the library's computer, so it can in real time send information about its location and all other things, how easy it can be. So there will be no need to manually enter all the details and the location of the book as soon as a new book arrives in the library. And if somebody replaces the book, it will be very difficult to find the book if we do not have this kind of a setup. So if we have these sensors and electronic tags on each book, even if somebody misplaces the book, it will be very easy to find the book. Now, for a moment, zoom out of the library and include the entire world. All the things, all the devices, all the equipments, refrigerators, microwaves, healthcare devices, everything include into this category, that all these things have these sensors or tags. They can talk to each other, communicate with each other, send information to each other over the network, over internet. Now, if that happens, this will be a whole world of connected things over the network, and that exactly is Internet of Things. If I go by the official definition of Internet of Things, it says IoT is a network of smart devices connected over internet, have ability to transfer data without human to human or human to computer interaction. So this is what an official definition say, that Internet of Things or IoT is a network of smart devices that have the ability to transfer data or communicate over the internet, and it does not require any human to human or even human to machine or human to computer interaction. So it is like the things or the components or the equipments itself can communicate with each other, and then they can pass the information. Take a very simple example. Suppose there is a vehicle which is equipped with IoT or Internet of Things. It has all the sensors that can take care of its health, its well-being. So these sensors can monitor all the checks in the vehicle. But if you think a step ahead, suppose, God forbid, there is an accident. If this vehicle is equipped with IoT, it can actually send information about this accident to the nearest police station or the ambulance with the exact location of the spot. So this is how you can think of Internet of Things. And if you take another example, suppose there is a village that does not have any connecting roads to the outer cities or any other town out of the village, but once these connecting roads are built, it can easily communicate with all the other towns and cities and villages, and can easily transfer goods and services and do all the interaction between all these towns and villages. So Internet of Things is a concept of smart devices available over the internet, which can talk to each other, which can communicate, transfer data without having any human interaction. So this was, in very simple words, the very basics of what IoT is. Now, if you are somebody who understands better with stories, I have written a story on what exactly is Internet of Things, and I will have the link in the description of this video so you can read that. And I will meet you in the next episode of School of Basics with a new topic. Thank you for watching.